One of the more frustrating yet common tasks in woodworking is cutting 45 degree miters. And cutting 45 degree miters is important because when you do woodworking, pretty much everybody wants you to make them a picture frame. Okay, so you get a 45 degree miter on the edges of picture frames, most commonly all sorts of other boxes and things like that. Also, I usually use my chop saw. What am I trying to say? My miter saw. But it doesn't do a very good job. And oftentimes, I'm sure you've seen this before, where you cut your miters and they're just like slightly off this way or that way. And well, if you're like me, probably what you end up doing is kind of mushing it together and then just kind of sanding over the corners and saying, it's done, it's perfect, just don't look at the miters. Now, of course, you could use also your miter gauge that comes with your table saw, but that doesn't work very well, at least on mine, because it has a little bit of a wiggle to it. Plus, it's really hard to get it set at 45 degrees. Well, it's really ridiculous that it's taken me this long to make an actual miter sled, a 45 degree miter sled for my table saw, and I wish I had done it years ago. There are a million different ways to make miter sleds, and you can get really complicated and fancy with them, but, well, this is what mine is. It's a plywood board and two chunks of wood, and I'm telling you, this thing works beautifully, and you can make it in about an hour. I've cut this chunk of 3/4 inch plywood pretty square on my table saw sled, but it doesn't really need to be that square. You just got to make sure you have one really flat edge. I've cut two long strips to use for the runners using 1/4 inch plywood, and they'll fit into these slots just like that. If you saw my crosscut sled video, you'll recognize what I'm doing here. I'm putting some nuts. You can use washers, whatever fits into those tracks, and then I can set the runner down on top of them just to get it slightly above the surface of the table. Now with those runners in, I've got them sticking out just a little bit beyond my table saw, and I'm just going to apply some glue all the way down each of the strips. I don't really need to do that top part. Now I can take that board I cut, and I'm just going to try to square it up with the end of my table just for now. I'm going to tweak it here in a second. Now I'm on this back edge of my table saw, and I'm going to use a combination square to line my runners up to the board, and I may have to just move it slightly. And you definitely want to take some time just to make sure that this is really square up against these runners. And once I got it into place, I'll just put some heavy weights on it and let it dry. And just to give these runners a little reinforcement, I'm gonna put a few screws in them. And I'll countersink the heads. Well, now I can flip it over and test it out and see how it runs. Not bad. And with the board in those runners, I'm just cutting it about halfway through. I'm going to use 1 inch thick boards for my two miter pieces. You could certainly use 3/4 inch, but I think I like the extra height that that gives me. So since I know that the front of this is square with my blade, all I'm going to use is my combination square and draw a 45 degree mark wherever I think, you know, maybe right about there. So I have a guide to set it up. I'm drilling some screws into these boards, but I only want it to go just to where it barely sticks out at the other end, where I can feel that point. Now what I can do is take this, got it going the wrong way, and line it up along that line. Now I can double check this and make sure I'm still at that 45 degree angle. Looks good. Then I'll press this board down so that I can get some marks there where I'll know where to drill a hole. Now I can screw this on in, and you know, I suppose you could just hold this down and drill that one hole and you wouldn't have to do that little marking maneuver on there. But the reason why I did that is, one, I was afraid that this might move and the drill holes might not line up perfectly. And secondly, I want to be able to, this top hole is a little bit wider, it's a little bit bigger than that one in the plywood, so that I can adjust this slightly if I need to. All right, now I can cut through the top board. Wow, after I cut that, I realized that I had this really too close to the edge here. So, yeah, because if I wanted to cut boards up here, it was just, well, too close. So I just backed it up a little bit. Live and learn. Now I can actually make my first miter cut on my miter sled, and I'll use this, assuming I'm still at 45 degrees, and I think I am. I can go ahead and run this next board through. I've done the same thing on this board. I put the screws in with them just barely sticking out. And this is really the most critical part of the entire sled, is making sure that this is an exact 90 degree angle. So I'm just putting a square up to it and lining it up and just being really careful about it, and then pushing it down in to get some marks. So that worked out pretty well. I've got a really nice 90 degree angle on that. And one thing I did is I moved this screw up here. This screw really wasn't in the right place. So I decided if I put this screw in, get it all the way in, then I can use that as a pivot to get it exactly where it needs to be. So that's why I moved the screw. And now I can just clean up this miter a little bit. So that's all there is to it. So if I wanted to make picture frames, I would just take a board and place it here. I could even clamp it down if I wanted to. And that's my first test cut, and whoa, that just fits together beautifully. And you know, I was even testing it out on a square here, and that's nice. Well, there it is. That's all there is to my miter sled. You could certainly enhance this in a lot of different ways. You could put some, you know, a lockdown clamp here to lock your wood in. You could put in some sort of stop block arrangement here. One thing I think I'm going to do is put a 2x4 here just to act as a blade guard. Thanks for watching this video. Go ahead and make one of those if you get a chance. It will really save you a lot of aggravation on cutting those 45 degree miters. I'll talk to you later.